And here we are, part 7. I got a interesting one for you today. There's gonna be some battle arena, there's gonna be some lower city apartments, some talking to some characters, a time skip because I skipped a good bit of me just screwing around in the upper city apartments, because I was just looking at inventory and, well, yeah, I skipped that. You're welcome. But let's talk to Carr, see how he's doing. Not like I really care.
Yes, what's on your mind?
Talk to me, boy.
I guess I did say you could ask me questions later, didn't I? Is this really necessary?
Yes, it is. Now, answer the damn questions.
We're pretty snappy with the orders, are we? Okay, you got it, sir.
Thank you. That's what I'm talking about. See, Arth?
The Endar Spire over and over in my head since we crashed. Some things just don't add up for me. Maybe you could tell me what happened from your perspective.
We were shot out of the sky. All but 3 of us died. You caught up?
Neither was I, to tell the truth. I was on board as an advisor for the most part.
What were you advising?
About to get so fast, it's anyone's guess as to what actually happened.
It wasn't the hyperspace route, was it?
A lot of good people.
I hope not.
What? In the hope that the Jedi powers would save us somehow?
Yes.
Not that Bastila had much of an opportunity to act. We didn't choose that battle anyway. It got forced on us.
Did it, though?
Hell, I'm just as surprised that any of us are alive to talk about it. Come to think of it, it's more than a little surprising that you happen to be here, isn't it? I mean, just what is your position with the Republic fleet anyway?
It's complicated.
A smuggler? I should have guessed. Now, isn't it odd, however, that a smuggler who was added to the crew at the last minute just happens to be alive?
I smuggled my life off the ship.
Don't be ridiculous. You've more than proved yourself since the crash. We wouldn't have made it this far without you, but still.
You're right. You wouldn't have gotten out of this room.
No.
Probably.
Maybe. Don't get me wrong. It just seems odd that someone Bastila's party specifically requested a transfer aboard.
Yeah, well, we're glad I'm here. Or, you know, dead.
The Jedi requested numerous things when they came on board. I mean, hell, they practically took over the ship, as far as I could tell. Considering your connection to Bastila and the Jedi, whether you know it or not, your presence here seems a little convenient. I'm probably
convenient for you.
And this is probably
you're still
nothing.
Breathing that oxygen
I've
stuff
been a long
that
time
you like.
Ago not to take things at face value ever, and I hate surprises.
I've got
I
a surprise.
Am with you. I'd be a fool not
in like 60
to. I'd also
episodes,
be a fool not
probably.
To expect the unexpected. Look. It has nothing to do with you personally. I don't trust anyone, and I have my reasons. And no, I'm not going to discuss them, so can we just keep our mind on more important things?
Like anything but you? Yeah, sure. How's your son doing?
All right. You're pretty damn tenacious. You know that?
I know.
We'll talk about it, but later. Right now, I just want to get going.
All right, and here in a moment, here comes the skip. You'll know. Look at Diet Chewbacca over there. I'm gonna say it's right after I fix up the sword. No, after the blaster. There we go. I talked to the guy who told me to go. Talk to Candorous.
How can I help?
And the shield guy.
I would like to know what happened after you crashed on Taurus. I'm curious as to what you and Karth were doing before we all joined.
We were slanging and banging through the hood. Literally, getting
I
territory.
I managed to free myself, as I recall. In fact, if I hadn't been there, Brezhik and his thugs might have killed you in that fight. It's probably more accurate to say that I rescued you.
Okay, I see your logic.
I'll admit that I probably wouldn't have been able to free myself if not for the brawl after the swoop place. I guess I should thank you for that, at least. Your presence at the swoop place, I'm curious about. It couldn't have been an easy task to find you there, yet somehow you managed. You also avoided detection by the Sith, discovered I was a Vulcan prisoner, gained sponsorship for the race, and became the Taurus swoop champion. That's quite a resume.
And rescued Amulet's Rift.
Yes. Well, I hardly consider myself a damsel in distress.
You were.
I'm a member of the Jedi Order, after all.
Barely.
I don't deny you've impressed me with what you've done. When you were chosen to join this mission, I doubt any of us expected this much from you. The Jedi
is that facts?
But only by drawing heavily upon the Force. Perhaps, but the Force works through all of us to some degree or another. There are some individuals outside the Jedi Order that we consider Force-sensitive. It's obvious to me that the Force has been working through you. There is no other explanation for your great success. Though I'm not certain what to make of this discovery. Perhaps if you weren't... Well, if you were younger, the Jedi might take you for training. But as it is...
Hey. What are you trying to say?
I've overstepped my authority. I'm speaking of things that are best left to the Jedi Council. For now, let's just accept the fact that you're gifted. Hopefully, between your abilities, my Jedi training, and the skills of our companions, we can find a way off this planet.
Good. Can I leave you all here? I'll accept Candorus. I gotta keep Candorus. That's my boy.
Hello there, youngster.
Shut up.
You interested in buying the Pazak? Just 50 credit.
Because Pazak is fun.
Don't get me wrong. The game's been good to me over the years. I've won countless fortune. That's why I'm looking to get up. No.
I'm a kid.
Leave me alone. I'm not giving out any auto prints to my fans today.
I'm not a fan.
So you're the one doing Zax's dirty work. Well, I've got some bad news for you, little bounty hunter. There's no way you're bringing me in. This cantina is wired with a top-level security grid. You pull a weapon on me and the auto-fire turrets will fry you before you can even pull the trigger. Why would I ever want to leave here? I've got food and drinks, place to stay, and everybody treats me with the respect I've earned for my dueling career. But if you're set on collecting that bounty, I'll make you a deal. I kind of missed the fight game. My hand is itching for the feel of a blaster in my grip. If you can prove yourself in the ring by beating all these other so-called duelists, I'll agree to face you in a deathmatch. You win, you get to collect the bounty for killing me.
Interesting.
Good luck with that, kid. You're gonna need it.
You sure you want to get involved in this? Seems a bit pointless to me. Up to you.
He's worth 500 credits, which is... astoundingly low for this.
I saw you in the swoop race. Very impressive. You seem like you know how to get results. That's just the kind of person I'm looking for.
Who are you?
My name's Candorus Ordo. I work for Davik Kang in the Exchange. The hours aren't great, but they promised me a fortune to work for them. And I have nothing better to do. Mandalorian mercs like me are in high demand. But lately, Davik hasn't been paying me what he promised. I don't like getting cheated.
I will help.
So I figure it's time for me to break the Sith quarantine and get off this backwater planet.
I'm down.
I've got a plan to escape Taris, but I can't do it alone. I need someone I know can get the job done to help me. That's where you come in.
Not Revan to the rescue.
Mercs like this having a lick of conscience. They'll betray you in a heartbeat. It's gonna be a trap.
I ain't talking to you. I'm talking to your friend, aren't I? I saw you win that swoop race and started thinking. Anyone crazy enough to race like that is probably crazy enough to break into the Sith military base. I need someone to steal the Sith launch codes from the base. Without those codes, any ship leaving the atmosphere will be disintegrated by the Sith fleet's automated defense guns. Here's the deal. You bring me those launch codes, and I can provide the vehicle to get us off the planet. Davik's flagship, the Ebon Hawk.
I'm listening.
Good luck. You're going to need it. The entrance to the base is sealed up tight. Getting in won't be easy. The Sith base is protected by an encrypted security system. It would take a top-of-the-line astromech droid to slice through it. Lucky for you, I know just the place to get a droid like that. Davik was having one custom built by Janice Nod. Just tell her Candorus sent you and she'll sell you the droid. Then you can use it to get the launch codes from the Sith base. Davik paid for the droid, but I'm the guy he put in charge of the mission. He won't care how I come up with those codes. Normally I'd do this myself, but everyone knows who I work for. If I broke into the Sith base, they'd send an army down on Davik's estate to get those codes back.
That's why I need you.
I don't sense any deception from him, which is surprising. This may be exactly what we need.
I'm going to wait in Javiar's cantina. You come and find me when you've got those launch codes, and I'll make sure we both get off this rock.
Sounds good to me. Sounds good to me. Yes.
Alright,
let's see how this goes.
Yeah. Charges power is my power.
Yeah, I forgot I already bought one.
Chio Kakon Bolera. Contra Pesha, Nova Moleraji.
Ladies and in this corner, one of the greats, a man so tough, even a disfiguring injury couldn't end his career. And in the other corner, a red.
Sideways. And frag grenade go burr.
Gerlong losing to a rookie! Is this a sign that his...
I can see it. I see it. I have no shame in my game.
Charges Kakon Punta. Kachiyo Kakon.
Let's go!
Chiyo Kakon Bolera. Conjo Pesha, Roba Moleraji.
Ladies and gentlemen, draw your eyes to the center ring. We have a very special over in this corner. A woman with steel on her bones and ice water in her veins. She's cold and quick as death and in.
Be able to cheese him, so I say nay. Ah, 2000 credit mechanics working flawlessly.
What happened to this drawing?
Oh.
Bastila, I was wondering something. How did those Vulkers manage to capture a famous Jedi like you? Were you knocked out when your escape pod crashed?
No, I was conscious. But my Force powers were exhausted from using my battle meditation in the battle for the Ender Spire.
Is that how that works?
Without my help, you might have never gotten off the ship alive.
Fair enough, but I've seen you Jedi in action. There's no way those thugs could have stood a chance against your lightsaber.
My lightsaber was misplaced. I couldn't find it after the crash. I looked everywhere in that part. The Vulkers came and overwhelmed me even as I was searching for my weapon.
Oh yeah, let me get this straight. You lost your lightsaber? I mean, isn't that a violation of some kind of Jedi code or something?
Oh, look. I'm invisible again.
This is no laughing matter. During the crash, my lightsaber must have fallen from my belt and rolled under my seat. The Vulkers probably found it there when they searched the wreckage.
Hey, don't get mad. I'm sorry. It's just funny to think of a legendary Jedi losing her lightsaber. Take my advice. This is one detail you might want to keep out of the history
text. I hardly consider myself a legend, Karth. Though I will consider your advice when I relate these events to the Jedi Council.
I'ma tell
them. There's no need for them to know every detail of what transpired.
I'ma tell them. Have you seen my alignment? I'ma tell them.
What do you want? Are you here to... I don't want any trouble. I'm just trying to keep my medical...
Shut up. Yeah, that didn't hurt my ear at all. Wearing headphones while I record.
Can't
this.
You see it?
I still messed up the radical serum thing. There goes my tube. Right?
Bastila, did you ever think about joining all the Jedi who were running off to follow Revan and Malak when they went to fight the Mandalorians?
That was nearly 5 years ago. I was still an apprentice. My battle meditation hadn't even manifested itself. Yet even then, I had the wisdom to obey the will of the Council.
I wouldn't call
Unlike
that wisdom, but...
I guess. All right. Still, do you ever wonder if things could have been different? Would Revan and Malak still have been corrupted if the Council had supported them instead of dragging its feet?
Do not blame Revan's corruption on the Council. Your Republic saw only the threat of the Mandalorians, but the wisdom of the Masters saw beyond the immediate threat.
Wisdom, you say?
There was something lurking out there. Something that devoured Revan and Malak, and many other Jedi. Had the Council sent us all into the unknown, how many more would have fallen?
So you're saying we should have done nothing? Just let the Mandalorians conquer us?
What's he saying?
I mean, the Republic was under attack, and the Order abandoned us.
We did not abandon you. But the Council were not about to throw lives away foolishly.
In time,
we would have aided you against the Mandalorians. But you couldn't wait. Revan and Malak offered a quicker answer, and the Republic chose to walk the easy path rather than the path of wisdom. Now we see the results all around us. You asked me if I think things could have been different. I know they could have. If Revan had only listened to the Council, millions of innocent people would still be alive.
That's a specific example. Is it because I'm standing right here?
I think... Let's just get back to the
task. I'm not
going to
remember that. Let's go get my droids. With intimidation, because I ain't paying that. You already know. If you didn't see this about to happen, if this is a spoiler, you clearly haven't been paying attention. Let me look.
With team member Rang Thong, Muli Ra on Shantoring Ni Patoga Wanga Chon Zi Tse.
Please speak basic. Mokau
Dang Ya Foki, Chachiska do Punta.
Yeah, no.
Watawama Muli Ri, King Kun Shopeshwa, No Ba Muli Raji, Jone Yuturi Yanchi, either Bola on Chi Chinek, Ba Muli.
Dark side points. I forgot to add the sticker. This video is gonna hang.
The evil walks among us.
Go back and put that in. I hope. all 27. Even though, like, you actually watch. That's right. I'm calling you out. Watch me. I'm funny sometimes. Probably. Okay, I'm somewhat moderately, maybe funny every once in a while. But hey, you never know when the chuckle's gonna come. So, like, yeah, you should watch it and stuff. Look at me surviving in combat. Somewhat of a chance, except for like against like the bosses. So there's that going for me. Specifically in a low-level area. I myself am indeed a low level. Ah, 2003 mechanics. Inability to walk. It's fantastic. Oh, look, stuff to sell. Because I am this bad and messed up the rat ghoul thing. Oh, I hate this puzzle. Well, let's get this. We can totally read it. Because I'm going to do this legit. Let's see here. Stuff. Up there it is. Alright. Okay. Let's read this then. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I don't read this slow. I'm not reading. I just have it memorized already. Totally have it memorized. I'm thinking. That is all I am doing, is thinking. Ignore that. That's fake. To be fair, I wasn't on Google. I was on Reddit. There's a difference. Kind of. Maybe? Okay, I looked it up. What you gonna do about it? I'm kidding. Please don't do anything. Wow. I was Googling for a long time. There we go. Now I'm looking at my phone and seeing who's who. Yeah. things I do for loot that will get outclassed in like 2 minutes. What's even in here? I can't remember. Oh yeah, 25 armor. It's not terrible for a light armor character. There's definitely better armors in the game, but it's upgradable, so it could be worse. I still have my favorite, the Republic mod armor, which I actually do have memorized.
No problem. Got it. Kipuna! Kavatumpa kupayi!
You're gonna die.
Watawamamulira King Kunjopeshak! No bamuliraji!
Maybe you shouldn't have been snitching.
No, wait. I want to hear what this man means by clear conscience.
I don't.
Kachichu aitha odunga. In King Kuno bamulirachi kun. Slima podonna.
By the rule of the
Kunhunkabi.
He must get stitches.
Tunipudu!
Except Rana no pra wound up in a ditch somewhere. Remember kids, it's not snitching if you're a victim. It is snitching if you're trying not to go into it. Moral of the story? Don't do what he did. About to be both apartments. If they can be killed in the lower city, I'm about to do it.
Here's a bounty on your little green heads. I'm here to collect. That's the plan.
They don't know. So what level are you? Alright. Just gonna... That happened. Alright! Back to the
How'd you like that?
I haven't even done it. Oh. This is like... Oh, okay. There we go.
Well, I'm here.
I did speak too soon.
What?
I will go these two episodes without death. Although, unlikely. Unless I can't remember.
How'd you like that? How'd you like that?
It's a March 8th as of.
How'd you like that?
Well, I cannot remember if I go a single episode without dying that involves combat. I think I'm
oh!
You shall fall!
Yeah, I'm thinking now. I don't think I did. That's my upgrade. that a lot. In the lower city, and under city, and bulk base, and back base. Yeah, I've died every episode, with the exception of the Endar Spire. But if you die on the Endar Spire, you're just trash. Take his stuff, because I'm pretty sure this guy's dead. Somewhere. I'm just gonna disable this mine. Hyperdrive! My uncle taught me how to shoot. And I'm from Alderaan. Haha! Bamboozled again. I'll take all that. Yeah, this is still better. I just love the public color. That's like how it looks. Don't know why. Always have. It's weird.
No problem. Got it.
Stop right there, or I'll give you a blaster shot right between the eyes. Now, what are you doing here?
Killing you.
You're a fool if you think you can collect the price on my head.
No.
Now you'll see why I'm the most dangerous assassin on Taris. The Force fights with me!
I know you got this. Oh, look, he wasn't too good. You're tied as Stormtrooper this time. I'm so proud of
him. I'm here.
Sure.
As ever with my weapon choices. Don't tell me you're surprised. I've done everything. No, I got one more place to live.
What's up?
If it can be killed in the lower city, then I have done it. Turning these bounties in, well, that's gonna be it for them, sir. That's what I want. Thank you all for watching. All 27 of my peoples. Let's go to that number.
I figured you'd be back. Neither of us is getting off this planet unless we work together. But we've got a small problem. I haven't heard about anyone breaking into the military base yet, so I know you don't have those departure codes. If you want me to help you, you've got to bring something to the table. So until you get... Getting in won't be easy. Lucky just...
things. If you like what you see, tell your friends. Simple request. With tuning while you drive. I don't know where I'm walking anymore. If you have a long commute to work, okay. 30 minutes. Y'all have a good day. Take care.